Welcome to the world of Hollywood merchandisers. Today we're going to take a few minutes of your time and show you our revolutionary products. One that you're probably all familiar with is the Hollywood crane. We've been manufacturing this for the last year and a half to almost 2 years. Very successful, very popular machine. It's known for being very reliable and for increasing location collections drastically. Then we're going to go on over and show you our new revolutionary baby. This is the Hollywood Skill Plower. Taking much time in research and development, we've finally brought to you a realistic looking body in which the public can relate to, as well as many attractions like our ramp which moves up and down during gameplay, all the attractive lighting sure to draw the customer over to the machine, the artwork which everyone finds attractive. You'll notice that a lot of the artwork even includes a lot of female figures, which makes this not just a game for men, but also for women and girls too. We have a special guest here today. We brought Ron Clapper in from our East Coast office. Ron, we'd like for you to come on out. Come on, please.
No problem. I love selling these Hollywood cranes. I flew in here the whole way from the East Coast. I'm out to sell you people cranes. I want to show you how easy it is to sell, buy, and operate these things. Where do you want to start, though?
Well, Ron, I would like to, I'm sure everybody's curious about our new Hollywood Skill Plower, which we've just begun shipping about the second week in July now. And I'd like for you to demonstrate this machine as how it operates and what makes this such a unique machine.
Okay. Now, first off, the more quarters you put in, the more time you get. So I'll operate this and explain it, and you ask the questions as we go, and maybe I can help out better that way.
That's a good idea.
Okay, push forward on the joysticks makes the dozer go directly forward.
Uh-huh.
Pull reverse on just one joystick or both, and it makes a turn. Notice how that thing pivots on a dime.
Sure does. That looks like a pretty precision piece of equipment. Let me ask a question about this, Ron.
Mm-hmm.
That dozer doesn't look like typical looking dozer. Now, the tractor and trailer idea, and especially going with this new ultra sophisticated Kenworth body style, seems to be a very interesting concept.
Well, it's interesting, all right. I certainly enjoy playing it more now that it's prettier.
I notice it lights on and off too as you're playing.
Yeah, the lights only light during gameplay. It's an added feature, a little bit more excitement in play.
Mm-hmm. Remarkable. Did you have this body built for you?
It was specially designed for Hollywood Crane by a company in Los Angeles, California.
Unbelievable. I have to go also.
Notice that illumination.
It sure does look good. Ron, what's the idea of the ramp moving up and down?
Well, player appeal for one. Second thing I would say would probably have to do with the percentage of payout. A little added player excitement.
That is remarkable. I bet that is really fun to play, trying to push something up the ramp, and you have to get it to the ramp, the top of the ramp, before it peaks out, if it's adjusted that way. But I imagine that you can also adjust it so it just gets harder to push to the top of the ramp at the end stroke.
Mm-hmm. Well, the height of your ramp is also adjustable, the maximum height. Ramp can be shut completely off if you want.
Are the speeds of the ramp going up and down, is that adjustable?
Yeah, it's adjustable by a simple knob in there. You turn it up and down.
And how about the begin stroke and end stroke of the ramp? How low it starts and how high it ends, is that adjustable?
Sure, that's all adjustable by brackets in there. Real simple adjustment also.
And how about the speed of the dozer here? Is that adjustable?
Sure, it's adjustable individual tracks. You can adjust the right track faster than the left. And
I see.
Down to a crawl, up to a full roar.
In other words, that gives the dozer a little bit more precision when both tracks are going at the same speed.
Yeah, you want to adjust them both in to match and even push, so when you push forward on the joysticks, it goes forward evenly.
Ron, I'll tell you, that sure is an extraordinary looking piece of equipment.
Yeah, I certainly like it.
The lights, the graphics, the dozer, the ramp, it's just amazing.
Definitely a nice compliment to our Hollywood line.
Just amazing. Well, now today I guess we're going to go over a few more things too. Our second chapter is going to be involved with features of the crane and the dozer. And then we're going to go into the options that are available for both of them. And then we're going to go into the serviceability and then right to pricing. We're going to talk about the anti-cheat preventions that each of these machines have incorporated in them. And then for the people that are interested, I want to spend a little bit more time. We're going to talk about details on why the Hollywood crane makes more money than any other crane on the market today. Same location, same product. And then we're going to talk about whether some operators that haven't yet got into cranes, do they really have a location for cranes?
Sounds great, Joe. Sounds like a full agenda for today.
Sure does. Well, Ron, we're going to sign off then, and we're going to come back and go into our second topic, which is going to be features. And thank you very much for your cooperation.
No problem.
Well, here we are. We're back again. This time, Ron and I are going to play a little game. What we're going to do is, we're sure that many of you have a lot of questions, and Ron is going to play the part of an operator and ask questions about why and how, and I'm going to answer them best I can, and hopefully we'll answer a lot of your questions. Ron, will you step out here, please?
To do here is I'm going to play the operator like he said, and I'm going to ask these questions, and Bill's going to give us the answers. First thing we want to go over is the first thing that catches your eye. Is it a rope lighting, the fancy graphics on the side, bottom, top, police light, everything you see there. Why should I buy this stuff, Bill?
Well, Ron, everything that you've just talked about is included in our Hollywood Flash package. This is all designed to attract a potential customer. In other words, if somebody's walking into location just for the sole purpose of playing a crane, this might not be as necessary to him as it is to somebody that's walking in that is going to walk by the crane and walk by without seeing it. The red light will reach out and grab the person's attention. Once it has his attention, he's going to focus in on the machine, the warm, soft graphics with the Hollywood thrill and image. And it's going to be attracted to the machine. At that point, it's up to the operator to have the plush in there that the player is going to be attracted to and want to put the deposit a quarter in for.
Okay, all good points. I guess the next thing probably is, which is probably self-explanatory, we'll go over, is this front door.
You like that?
I like that a lot. What was the point in doing that first off, other than the obvious?
Well, Ron, the front door was designed to open with one key because that's all that's necessary. This machine, our older model, for instance, had about 6 or 7 different keys, like most of the competitors out there. It's very annoying for an operator, and it's not practical. This is an all-metal construction cabinet, and because of that, we don't have a lot of particle board that we need to put a lot of different locks on to secure it. We have all metal, we don't need only one key and a lock, a latch system to secure this machine. So therefore, this adds quite an advantage to the operator. We open the machine very easily with one key. He can get in and service anything he might want to service. He can get into his plush storage. He can get in and stock his plush area. Or work on the mechanism very easily. Change light bulbs, whatever. Everything is at arm's reach. Back to you, Ron.
Okay, well, one of the first things I see when I open this door is, we'll start with that stuff, which I'm sure they can see. Let's start with the metal. I see metal everywhere.
Metal. All metal construction. all metal construction. Not only metal, but it's also plated, so it's rust resistant. This machine is built for longevity. Longevity for income, longevity for profits, durability, and serviceability. This is what it's all about. This is not, repeat, this is not a video game cabinet with a claw in it. It is not made out of flake board and hot glued and stapled together. This is an all-metal construction machine built of superior parts that is bolted together and designed for years and years of lasting durability and attractiveness.
Okay, while we're on the cabinet here, I noticed a few other things that I could point out is this here is glass.
That's right. Glad you asked, Ron. This is probably one of the most important parts about the crane. It not only adds durability
on the cabinet
to the crane, but it it also adds years of lasting clarity. This is quarter-inch tempered plate glass. Now,
I notice that's on the side too.
It's on the sides. It's on the front. And in our four-sided viewing cabinet, it's also on the back. Do you know about our four-sided viewing?
Yeah, I did. I understand that's real well in convenience stores and stuff.
It is designed solely for the purpose of convenience stores, 7-Elevens. It's the Stop and Goes and U Totems, as well as many grocery stores and department stores. Anywhere where you can place a crane that goes up against a glass window, it's perfect. The potential player sees this product before he walks into the location, and chances are you'll catch him before he goes and does any shopping or any of the business he's going in there for, as well as on the way out.
On that option, I'm sure it costs more, but now it puts the glass in. Does it put graphics back there also so it looks good?
Absolutely. When you order the four-sided viewing machine, you not only have four sides of quarter-inch tempered plate glass, but you also have a graphics package on the bottom, which really enhances the appearance of the back of the machine. It doesn't get stuck up against a wall. So if you have an area location where you can place a machine against a window or in the middle of a floor, you definitely want the four-sided machine. All right, Ron, sorry for the inconvenience there. Okay. We're not professional photographers, I guess.
Far from that, I'm no professional actor either. All right, I'm noticing your coin door system here also. Mm-hmm. Maybe you can tell me about that.
Well, that seems to be the standard of the industry, and anybody who operates amusement devices knows that this is what they want. This is the CoinCo coin door system with the security lock cash box. The cash box can be locked from this point, which I'm focusing in on right now. You put a padlock there, which guarantees nobody but you or the person who holds the key to that padlock is going to be able to get in that cash box. Also, that cash box is not able to be removed except for through the front door. So in other words, just a very high security cash box. You can give attendants, location owners, your service personnel keys to the machines, but they'll never be able to get at the cash. And as far as the coin door system goes, this is expensive for us, but through industry surveys, we found that this is what the operator wants. They don't want the half coin door or single coin slot entry.
All right, notice on your cash box there that you have 2 meters. I'm sure after operating cranes there, we know that 1 meter is for the coins in, and the other meter is for?
The other meter is for the flush. It tells you the amount of flush that has been vended through the machine. Therefore, it's good for auditing purposes as well as accounting purposes. It helps you justify product costs to location owners.
All right, nice little option. Well, next on our list here, I guess, we have your mechanism. One of the most important parts of the crane, I guess, that everybody has always a million questions about. Can you tell me a little about this? This isn't the Belgian mech, I can see, right?
No, it isn't. Surely isn't. Belgian mechanism, which most people use, is a mechanism that was designed a long time ago, older technology, and today our technology that we have available to us is much greater. The mechanism, first of all, is built out of very high-grade polished stainless steel, which will guarantee long luster appearance for years and years. The mechanism, when we designed it, Ron, we said, look, what does a player want? He wants reliability, ease ability if anything ever does go wrong. And he wants something that runs and runs smoothly, that the player's going to be satisfied controlling. It's not going to cheat the player. So this, with some of these important factors in mind, we've designed this mechanism, and it does just that. The mechanism consists of three motors, which are all the same, and they are all interchangeable with each other. It consists of four micro switches, which two are the same. It consists of a claw coil, which is built according to our specifications, and it's a very high grade coil in which will not melt down nor burn out if something happens and where the claw should be stuck out in the play area for very long. Also, Ronnie, would you push the mechanism back a little bit? I'd like to focus in on another very important feature. A lot of cranes have a lot of downtime because the machines are rocked and tipped, and at that point the wheels come off of the track. And what happens is the machine is out of commission and has come off track. Our machine is designed to wrap around the bar, so therefore it can never come off a track. It's like the new roller coaster, and there's just no way that this machine for the carrier or the cage unit will ever come off track. So people can turn the machine upside down, no problems. Also, I want to point out that all the cabling that is done to the mechanism is done through the top of the machine, not going up the side. It does not obstruct the view of the product, nor does it enhance the product appeal. Most cranes on the market have a very sore, ugly-looking cord that comes up from the bottom of where the plush is, and it's just not a place for that. You've got a really beautiful showcase here that shows off the product, that stimulates the public. Why put something sad deterrent in there? Ron, would you like to for us to film the mechanism moving back and forth to show how smooth it operates and such?
Sure.
All right, so we're going to watch the mechanism move back and forth. Now we're noticing that as this goes over to the right-hand side, that claw finger touches the glass. Move that back against that window again there, Ron. The claw finger actually touches the glass and rubs against the glass. This is what the player wants. The player wants to have the availability of picking up product, whether it's in the center of the machine, or whether it's in the corners, against the glass, against the walls, whatever. He wants to have, and a lot of legalities have to have this too, but he wants to have equal opportunity to pick up that product regardless where it is. And we're demonstrating that by the fact that that claw moves over and actually touches the glass on left and right-hand side as well as the back mirror to give the player the ability to be able to get that product. The mechanism runs very, very smoothly. And again, let's watch that finger. That finger touches the glass. The mechanism runs very smoothly. The claw will drop here, come back up. Running very smoothly, not shaking anything out. Come back home and drop it. Ron, is there any other questions here?
Well, some of the things you covered, a lot of them there. I guess maybe the string. You know, we have a lot of problems in the industry with the string breaking and stuff.
The string is a very special string. It's not typical for the industry. The industry standard is a very small, frail, thin string. That's dangerous because the string breaks often, and when it breaks, generally it breaks in the home position. And if it breaks in the home position, the claw is generally lost through the drop box opening. This doesn't happen all the time, but it does happen. Not with this. As you can see, we have a retractable cable there, which if this string would ever break, which it won't, but if it ever would, the retractable cable would stop the claw from falling down through the drop chute to where somebody could remove it from the machine. And this is, again, a precautionary measure. The string, however, is a very, very tough string made out of some sort of a nylon, Delcron, and it's basically a string within a string within a string, and it's larger in diameter than an eighth of an inch. It's a very large string, and it's very flexible. Yes, Ron? Would there be anything else that you would might like to talk about?
Okay, well, that pretty much covers a mech. Maybe we could take a break right now and then come back into something.
Okay. Let's do that then.
Tell me when.
All right, back to you, Ron.
Okay, Bill, we talked about a little bit here about security. Now, this dozer, there was one thing. I understand that the other one on the market is real easy to cheat.
Okay? Yes.
So one of the things I wanted to ask you was, what do you do to keep them from cheating it?
Well, that's one of the problems with having a dozer and pushing something up a ramp is that if the player gets something at the top of the ramp and he picks up the machine, it's going to obviously fall in. As well as if the machine is unplugged at nighttime, it's easy to tilt the machine and have the product fall down the hole. We've done this set us back probably by about 2 weeks to finally get these particulars worked out. I want to show you our security measures on this dozer.
Okay.
I'm going to go down in the dozer here now, and as you can see, here's our ramp that moves up and down. And you can see the opening there. Now, actually in there's a flap door. This door, if somebody picks up the machine or bumps it or tilts it, it has a pendulum in this machine like it's in a pinball machine. Once it touches and makes contact, it'll shut the flap door for 5 seconds. Now that's the first protective measure that we have taken. And I'll demonstrate that. Ron, would you like to take and bump the machine for us?
If I just tilt this machine, that flap will close.
Exactly. As you can see, it's closed for 5 seconds.
Automatically releases then, huh?
Automatically releases. Now, also, the other problem that we have, I mean, here when the machine is plugged in, no problem. I mean, they cannot rip off this machine. The minute they get it up to the top of the ramp, that door closes if they tilt the machine. The other problem is if the machine is unplugged, and I'd like to demonstrate that. Ron, would you unplug the machine for us, please? And let's see what happens when the machine is unplugged. As you can see, the machine has quit. Our orchestra also quit. But the machine has stopped and the flap is the whole way up. Unless this machine is plugged in and has power, the flap remains closed like this all the time. It's battery backed up. We feel the battery will last. If the machine is unplugged once a day, the battery should last for over a year. Now let's plug that machine back in once, Ron, and let's go on to another topic.
Okay.
There's virtually no way that the dozer machine can be ripped off. No way. No way. We've taken precautionary measures. And to control the skill level of the person that's needed for the person to dispense product, we have taken care of that by giving you the optional speeds on the dozer, the track, individual track speeds on the dozer, as well as the ramp. Height adjustment, as well as the ramp speed. There's adjustments on this dozer to accommodate any situation and any product. Okay, Ron. While we're on security, why don't we go over to the crane and talk about the security drop box?
Okay.
Because as you probably are familiar with, a lot of people that are watching this are familiar with the fact that there is a lot of theft going on in the industry today. When you place a crane in a location, as typical or with a typical crane, you have to place it into a location in which you have security, where you have an attendant nearby. A Hollywood crane can be placed anywhere, not need to have an attendant nearby. There's two ways of ripping off cranes. One is that they're ripping the crane off by tilting the machine forward on its face. And the product rolls on the glass. When they set the machine back up, it rolls down the chute, and the people get it. Now, the second problem is that they're using clothes hangers to push to go up through the chute into the play area and get product out. Now, we've taken care of both of these problems. Ron, I'd like to pay for you to push that push door. While we look down in here, we got a little bit too much of a glare.
Okay, you want the machine open then?
Let's open the machine. All right, now let's take a look at this push door. I'm going to look down inside of here. And maybe we should throw a piece of plush down there so we can see it.
One piece of plush.
Now, the idea is that when you push open the push door, go ahead, Ron. As soon as you start to push it open, it closes the entire unit off. And if you push it open enough, you can get your hand in there, the unit is sealed. Now, most clothes hanger theft is happening by store or location personnel. Most of it is inside work. However, in unsecure areas, clothes hangers, Slim Jims, hands, they get up inside of here and steal the plush, but not with this drop box. This is it's also a standard piece of equipment which comes with the glamour package as well as the flash package.
Yeah, Bill, there's one thing that isn't on my list here that just occurred to me is what size plush can we use in after this thing? What size?
Well, Ron, you can use any pre-pack that's on the market today, basically. This will take as large a plush as any crane on the market today. And plus, it'll take even a little bit larger. We recommend not exceeding 10 inches. Now, true, you can put 12 inches, 14 inches in here, but you're going to have problems. It's going to get stuck. So we recommend not going to that limit.
So basically, the claw will pick up anything that will fit down the drop box.
The claw can be adjusted to pick up anything within reason that you could put into the plush cavity. It will pick up hard plastic items, it'll pick up small, heavy items, it'll pick up large, heavy items or small, light items, and compared to large, light items. It can be adjusted to pick up just about anything.
Even jewelry?
Even, absolutely. That's the way it was designed. It's a very versatile piece of equipment.
All right. I guess next on my list that I noticed while he was going over was this plush storage. Seems to be huge.
Well, there's a lot of plush in here. We recommend that this machine would be full. We recommend that all the Hollywood cranes be operated with this level of plush. The reason is the magnitude. This plush just is very appealing to the eye. If we had 2 or 3 inches of plush in here, it wouldn't be as appealing. So this has a magnitude that just looks terrific, and obviously it attracts a lot of quarters. This is full. Empty to us, and empty to a Hollywood crane owner, should be about 6 to 9 inches of plush, which would be full, be a full capacity to most other cranes on the market. It also has a large plush area in the bottom which you could store plush. Now, as I began to mention, and we got off the subject, Ron, that there's two ways of ripping off the machine. One is the clothes hanger, we've eliminated that. No clothes hanger, Slim Jim, hands, or anything's going to get up inside this machine. You don't have to be concerned with that. The only other way that they're going to rip off this machine is if they tilt it face forward, the product rolls on the front glass, they stand it back up, and it rolls down into the drop chute. We have taken a precautionary measure, and we have gone with a very, very extra heavy steel bottom and very heavy rated casters on the bottom, so you can add up to 1,500 pounds of additional weight to the bottom of this machine, by the way, of sandbags, cement blocks, concrete, whatever you want to put in here, you can put in here, and it will assure you that this machine will not be tipped over. The machine is bolted together, not hot glued and stapled together like a lot of competitive models. It is bolted together, metal and metal. And you can also bolt it to the floor if you like. Anything else there, Ron?
Okay, well, the one other thing is the size of this. Now, I understand you have other sizes available. Maybe you can hit me on something like that.
Well, this is our single 27 model. This is about an average size for the industry. There are several cranes out that are just a little bit smaller than this. We have a smaller model, which is a single 24. This is the most common, this particular crane. It's 27 inches wide and 81 inches high. This crane holds about 30 to 36 dozen plush, depending on average size. This machine will hold almost four times as much plush as some comparable models.
Okay, well, got a lot of features to it. Stuff. Is there any options that's not on this crane that might be available?
Yes, we do offer a dollar bill acceptor, one and $5 bill acceptor that is not shown on this machine. It's available, as well as we mentioned the four-sided viewing.
Okay. All right. Well, that pretty much covers it.
Yeah.
I do want to say one thing. I hope that you guys get a little bit out of this. Bill and I had a little fun here with the features. Some of the questions I hope you answered. We're no actors and no cameramen, like we said. Basically, we've done everything we can to show you there's no other reason to buy anything but a Hollywood crane.
Right, Ron. I think the point we're trying to get across here is this is a quality product. It's a third generation crane. We were building a crane a year and a half ago that was very much like our competitors that have them out in the market now. When we wanted to our crane to perform to standards that we wanted, it was impossible to get it through the crane that we had. So we had to step back and go with an ultra new generation of a crane, third generation. And we've got it here. And I'll tell you something. Our customers that operate these know exactly what we're talking about. And we challenge anybody to put one of these cranes in a location where they are operating a crane now, side by side, or replace, and put the same flush in, the same location, and we guarantee that this machine will at least double collections long term. The customers walk away from this machine with a very satisfied feeling, and that is our key. We get them there, and we keep them there.
One more thing we might want to do, Bill, is go over these features.
Very quickly?
Yeah, very quickly, one by one, what we have that the competitors don't have.
Good idea. Let's do that, Ron.
Okay, I'll think of some. You help me, okay? Tempered glass.
Quarter-inch tempered plate glass, that's right.
Okay. Flush capacity is at least double?
Probably we could say triple.
Okay. And metal cabinet?
All metal construction, absolutely. Okay.
The over-under coin door system?
A few people have it, but not many. Not many at all.
Security drop box, nobody.
Absolutely nobody has taken the time to give the operators a theft-proof security drop box system. I mean, why? I don't know. It was expensive for us, and we did it in our third generation crane, which wasn't in our second generation. But
a lifetime warranty.
Lifetime warranty on the mechanism, a one-year warranty on the board. Unbelievable. And also, I want to mention we do have an on-field service kit available, which has three motors, it has four switches, an extra coil, claw cord, string, a bag of nuts and bolts. Anything that could possibly go wrong with this crane on location, 99% of the times anyhow, will be covered in this on-field service kit, which we recommend the operator buying. He won't need it for a long time, but when he does need it, it'll be there.
Great point. Now, does anybody else offer that service kit?
I don't know.
Okay.
Not that I know of.
The ugly cord in the cabinet?
No, I'll tell you, that was a painstaking task, getting rid of that cord, but it's benefited. Why other people don't do it? Well, look, Ron, the reason why the other people haven't done it is they're building cranes that were designed many years ago, and to change and go over to a product like this is going to be very costly, time-consuming, and I don't know. I can't speak for them.
Mechanism won't drop off the track.
Absolutely.
Anybody else have that?
Absolutely. Not that I am aware of. This machine, again, machine can be go into a very non-security area. The kids can bounce it around, throw it against the wall, do anything they want. Because of the construction of all metal, and because of the machine being built with the respect of a vending machine in mind, they're not going to have the kind of abuse they would on the machines that are on the market today that are built out of particle board and hot glued and stapled together that look like video game cabinets with claws stuck in them.
How about our component system? Does anybody have that?
No, again, everything is broken down very modular. If by chance somebody that had to repair this machine that didn't know anything about repairs could easily take out our mechanism, our board, or any other part that the harness, whatever it might be. But this isn't a common situation. I can't ever recall.
So basically, What we're saying is nobody looks as good, nobody works as good, and nobody sees behind him as good.
Ron, three important parts, but the most important part is ROI. Nobody can complain about the return on investment of this crane. It's phenomenal. This crane will make a tremendous amount of income compared to competitors' units. That's it. I mean, if you're going to invest the money in a crane and you're looking for longevity in the location, there is only one crane. This is it. Absolutely.
So the bottom line is they work.
And they make money.
Okay. Anything else, Bill?
No, I think that we should come back a little bit later and discuss prices.
Okay.
Maybe we'll do that next. Let's go on a station break here and come back and discuss some prices.
See you in a minute. Okay, I guess we're back at you now.
Back at us, Ron.
Now, the first thing I guess, Bill, to say is, let's say we're going to play our little game again, question and answer. And now you've got me sold, all right? So now what I want to do is I want to introduce my friend Bill, our West Coast office, and we're going to drill him on the questions of price, how I go about buying one of these, delivery time, all that stuff. Come on in, Bill.
How you doing, Ron?
How you doing, Bill?
Good. Well, listen, what kind of questions can I answer for you?
Well, okay, the first thing maybe is, let's say I decide to buy one of these, my first step.
Well, the first step is contact your distributor. Call your distributor and let him know what you want to buy and that you're looking at Hollywood products and learned about them. You gotten literature through the mail, through us, or through him, and now you want to purchase one. If your distributor in your area, we don't have a distributor in your area that does not sell the Hollywood cranes, you can buy Factory Direct. And Factory Direct we offer for the people that are not represented by a distributor who carries Hollywood line, we offer financing as well as some nice lease programs.
Okay, now I understand there, maybe we can clear this up, as we do have an East Coast office and a West Coast office.
That's right.
Any preference there? Just call the one closer? Or?
Yeah, call the one in your area. Basically, it makes no difference which office you call. Both stock the same merchandise, and same equipment, and prices are the same. And I do want to say something, too. I mean, we've obviously showed you a lot of things here that look expensive. Don't be fooled. They're not expensive. This crane, with the Hollywood flash package on it, can be bought for probably as much as you're paying for equipment now, for cranes now, if not less. And the Dozer is already our starting price on our Dozer is comparable to our competition. This Dozer costs no more than our competitor's Dozer, but it has many more features that will make you money and keep the customer coming back. That's one important thing.
Good. Sounds real good. Now, maybe you mentioned both ways there. Go through our distributor or go Factory Direct. Maybe the first thing to say, let's give examples of both ways. Okay, you go to your distributor, I guess you pay for it, it's yours, you know what I mean, as long as they have it in stock.
Right.
Okay, the next step would be, I call you, what's our procedure? We send in the money, delivery time.
Basically, turnaround time is very good. Right now, as we're filming this, is the third week in July, and we're shipping both units. Cranes, we build quite a few number of cranes. Our sales are constantly increasing, but the availability on cranes in most sizes, we have five different sizes, most sizes are in stock, and they're generally, once credit is approved, or once we receive deposits or the full payment on the machines are generally turned around within a 24-hour period. Dozers right now, assembly has just begun on these recently, about a week ago, and we're building them. We have quite a few orders to get caught up on, but however, get your name in. Right now, about a week and a half to 2 weeks turnaround time.
Okay, we are talking about delivery. In all our national ads and everything, we show a upright dozer.
The upright dozer we expect to come along probably about the first or second week in August. This piece of equipment is not going to fit in an area in which does not have a very large door or a double entry door. The unit is about 44 inches wide. This piece is doing very well in street locations as well as arcade and high traffic locations. Therefore, we're coming out with an upright dozer, which is remarkable. Much the same as this, it's a very, very attractive looking unit. Very remarkable, very pretty.
Okay, next step, I suppose, is common carrier trucking.
Yeah, everything is shipped on truck. And I do want to bring out that because of the massive amount of equipment that we ship, we have worked to deal with a couple of different truck lines, major truck lines, that we get a 46% discount on shipping, and which we pass directly on to our customers. We can take that discount, 46%, and have it kicked back to us if we choose. And I know a lot of competitors do that. They'll ship the equipment out, take their discount, regardless whether it's 20% or 46%, and get a kickback to them and keep it for themselves, not us. Listen, we pass it right on to our customer.
Well, it's made pretty simple for us as far as purchasing. We mentioned the guarantee. I guess we want to mention that we do have price sheets included with the tapes.
Yeah, now when you get the videotape, you'll have a price sheet which is included. But again, I want to stress that we hope that a distributor is representing the Hollywood line in your area. That's our intentions. But because we are a fairly new company and distributors have had lines of cranes already established with other of our competitors, distributors are slowly coming over to us. And during this process, we have to stop selling factory direct in those areas in which we sign up distributors with our floor plans and turn you over to those distributors. But like I say, call your distributor. If they don't have it, call us. If we don't have a distributor representing your area, buy factory direct. Be great.
Okay. Our 800 numbers are on the...
Our 800 numbers are going to be listed on the brochures or on the price list in which you get. You can call us toll-free 800. Is there anything else there, Mr. Clapper?
Well, I'm thinking. It's made pretty simple, I'll tell you that.
Very simple. Very simple. We were the last manufacturer, one of the last manufacturers to get into the crane market. When we got into the crane market, there were 18 different manufacturers. We came into the crane market with pretty much the same piece of equipment they had. And there's only so much you can do with a wooden cabinet that's glued and stapled together, and that's formica together. And there's only so much money you can make. And in designing the machine, we had Los Angeles Vice down to our facility, and they gave us some tips on what they wanted this machine to be capable of doing for Los Angeles. Los Angeles is a very, very, very tough area to get anything approved. They were nice enough to work with us and show us what we had to have. We couldn't achieve it. What they wanted and the demands they put on us, we could not achieve through our wooden model machine. And we had to come out with something like this, in which we figured we're going to do it, might as well do it right. Let's build it right. We have. And we have it available to the market. And we stand behind it. This is our product, which has just come out in July of 1987. And all ready for the show in Chicago this fall. We have another new machine coming out in July 2. And I want to point out too that this machine is not making the crane obsolete. No way. This is a great compliment. It's like having two video games in a location. One game doesn't outdo the other. All you do is you attract more attention, more traffic, more players. This is a great enhancement to the cranes. Believe me. Believe me. Crane and collections will increase with this machine beside it.
It's great, sounds like a great opportunity there.
Great opportunity, absolutely. And I want to mention too that we have been shipping this machine right now. And think about this. We've been shipping this machine for about a year and a half, I guess, this particular machine. First of all, you won't find a used Hollywood on the market. And if you do, it's retaining between 80% and 90% of its value. Now, look at our competitors' cranes and ask that same question. One of the reasons why our competitors' cranes are starting to become available in the market, and one of the reasons why they are dropping in value, is because, this is the truth, we have a lot of people that have competitors' models, maybe you, that have gotten to Hollywood. They love it. They put it in the same location. It makes a lot more money. And they want to sell off their old equipment and update the Hollywoods. This is happening all over the place right now. And I'll tell you, it just makes me feel so good that this is happening. We said it was going to happen a year ago, and it's happening now. It's if you're operating cranes, try just one of these. Put it in a location, side by side, your best location, your best crane, and I guarantee, we guarantee, that this machine will at least double your collections. We've proved it over and over again. And once that happens to you, you want to sell off everything that you've got. And you want to replace your crane locations. You want to replace your cranes with Hollywoods. This is happening all over the country, and it's true. These Hollywood cranes are an entirely new and different investment than the cranes that are on the market from our competitors. This crane is built for longevity. It's built with the player in mind. It's built to give the player an honest chance at showing his skill levels to receive a product without ripping them off. No dead space. Everything is equally accessible.
Let's talk investment for a little bit here, if we can. Like I mentioned, I operate a route back east for us. Is there any better investment on the market right now than a crane?
I would have to say absolutely not. Of course,
I guess the key word is probably new money.
Well, here's the thing, Ron. Everybody that's watching has their own formula of penciling out an investment. I can only tell you that if you pencil it out, most likely you're going to come up with no. There isn't a single thing in this industry that you can invest in that's going to give you a better return on investment than a crane. Why? One of the biggest reasons is, let's take a hypothetical situation where we have four video games, and now we're going to invest $2,500 to update those four video games. You got a location average of $300 a week, let's say, you're in. Now it comes time you invest $2,500 to update that location. If you spend $2,500 updating the location with a jumbo-sized Hollywood crane, for instance, or any Hollywood crane, you are going to pull additional income out of the location. Your location average goes up, way up, because now you have video income as well as merchandiser income. Now, if you're going to invest in a crane, you want to look at the crane that's going to give you the best return on investment, the best value. And that's this one. So therefore, pencil it out. Look at it. Crane in just about any location will do well, providing this merchandise properly. And that's your job, to make sure that you have. The big key is to make sure that you have something in that machine that your customer or potential customer finds desirable. Our job is getting them over to your machine and giving him an honest and fair opportunity to get that product. And with you doing your job and us doing ours, you're going to have a satisfied customer and you're going to have a full cash box.
I guess there's no secret about it. Redemption's always been pretty much a backbone of the amusement industry. And there's a future in it.
Oh, absolutely. Redemption's coming around now, very strong. Like I say, this is our second venture, and our third, which we're showing later this year, is going to be remarkable too. We have many things lined up even for next year, but it's going to be one-on-one, and they're going to be compliments to each other. It's going to be 3-4 years from now, you're going to be able to walk into a location, and literally, you'll see a line of Hollywood products all sitting there, still looking as good as they do today, still making money.
Sounds great, though. I think we've covered a lot of things into pricing here. Maybe one thing we want to do is for our next and last segment is explain maybe why they want to buy the Hollywood over another crane and what is more detail on it.
Well, I'll tell you something. I think that we've covered enough. Why they want to buy a Hollywood over another crane is very simple. The only thing we want you to do, whether you're a distributor or an operator, I don't care who, compare just compare. That's all. Once you compare feature for feature, option for option, product for product, you're going to buy Hollywood. There's just no other way around it. You're going to buy Hollywood. Once you buy your first Hollywood, you bought your last competitor, one of our competitors' cranes. You'll be buying Hollywoods all along. The best comparison is to buy one of these, put it side by side, your best crane, the one that you think is nice. Your best crane, best location. It'll blow it away. That will sell you. Experienced a couple technical difficulties there, Ron, but I think that we're just about done telling people about our products, and I think the rest is up to them. Compare and choose.
I certainly hope. I've suffered enough embarrassment today on this movie. I hope we got our point across.
I hope so, too, but I think that if there's any other questions that anybody has, you're welcome to call us. And as far as distributors are concerned, anything that we can do for you, give us a call. Any sort of support or anything. So I think that everybody will be anxiously waving their dozers. This is definitely the hot piece right now. But again, it's a heck of a compliment to the crane. We have found by putting the dozer in a location next to a crane, it's increased the collections on the cranes.
Well, I hope we've answered a lot of your questions. If not, you can feel free to call us at your numbers, the 800 numbers, that's for sure. You can talk to Bill on the West Coast, or me on the East Coast, or any of our salesmen there, and they can all help you with it.
Any of our salespeople can give you a hand as well. All right, well, thank you very much. And Ron, thank you for stopping out.
Hey, it's been nice having you, Bill.
Really, it's really nice stopping when you stop in. We'll see you later, Ron.
Okay.